Hello, I am Bentham, and welcome back to Factorio Living with Biters, where in the previous episode we were sorting out a bunch of upgrading. We got everything switched to level 3 assemblers with efficiency modules in them. We're only missing modules now and a couple of furnaces and things like that that we'll be able to work on. We currently have level 2 efficiency modules in production. There's an attack going on for the stone deposit. That's probably fine. There's not much in there that is in particular danger. But yeah, so the end of the last episode, I was doing some messing around with this. I put a limit on this chest, but I think I should just change how this works entirely. Because at the moment, there's just not enough iron coming through here. We've already got this deposit and the deposit up there going full pelt. It's all going straight through the buffers, straight into the furnaces, and there are still furnaces that are occasionally not running. So I think rather than just like reduce what's being taken from here, we should just put stuff in instead. So what I'm going to do is set up... Let's have a couple of requester chests. I'm just going to switch this to a requester, because we already have providers up here. Our little iron buffer system. It doesn't... Well, it's not even a buffer system. It just goes into providers and then sits there. So we could just request that in. Have that bolster the supply of iron into the main system. The issue with it, though, is the bots, because... They've got a long way to fly and a very large amount of stuff to deliver. Maybe like, there's a possibility that I could do some clever stuff and have like all that iron be turned into steel and then ship the steel over, because then it's 1/5 of the load, because one steel is 5 iron. And then just have no steel production over here instead of something like that. At the moment, the steel's looking pretty good. I can't tell if they're all off or not. Hang on. 3 of them are on. All the ones up here are on. Could definitely be better, but some stuff's building up. Actually, that was another thing I was thinking of. People have been saying I should probably... Hang on, let's copy and paste this, because I want to have 3 chests so that we can have a decent amount of throughput. This could go wrong. It probably will go wrong, to be honest, but I think... It might just be a temporary mess-up before things sort of calm down and recover. That's the hope. Put that in there, and then that's all running. What's in here at the moment? All sorts of random bits. Well, we can take that, because at the moment we have some fast belts anyway. These inserters, can I, like, put them into the inserter production over here? Yes, I can. Makes things a little bit neater. Oh, and there's a bunch of power poles as well. I just crafted some more of those. Everything else, pretty much leave it, I think. We've got stupid amounts of provider chests at the moment. But yeah, let's check the bot system. Okay, so all of the 450 logistics bots are currently operating. Which is unfortunate, but I think it'll be a temporary... Wow, look at them all coming in. Wow, they're from everywhere, because they're all having to recharge on the way, so they end up coming from... all over the base. But yeah, the hope is that these will... Oh, that's interesting. I didn't know we copied the limits. Interesting indeed. But actually, what we can do is just grab a bunch of these and dump them into these. And that will, I think, fully fix it, actually. So that's pretty good. So there we go. The bots no longer have any work to do. They're still in the process of delivering stuff. Which is fine. So now these will unload onto here. And they'll just help bolster the iron supply. So that's looking pretty good. It's getting to the end of the circuit production. Though the belt balancing could do with a bit of rejigging. Unfortunately, there's not much room. I'll have to do a sort of half fix, I think. If we did that, that would sort of help. We might want this to be fast belts. I mean, it's fast belts right up to here, so that would probably make some sense. It does get split immediately, but the splitting... Currently there's nothing going on with that. That's the iron supply for Blue Science. I don't know if any iron is actually used by Blue Science or would ever need to be used at the moment. But we'll make all this red. Because we have the belts handy anyway. And it might be useful. We could get the reds going halfway into the circuit production, then it would definitely help. But at the moment, it seems to be fine. Copper is not amazing. But, not terrible either. It's getting most of the way there. The belts are all nice and full as things stand. But yeah, this should help a bit, and if we want to request iron, we can get it from the northeast anyway. Now, another thing I wanted to do is, some people have said that one chest full of ammo will not be enough. At the moment, we're apparently just... Oh, I guess it's being used to make those, or something like that. That's probably what it is. But yes, people have said, like, get another chest full at least, or something, because... I'm going to be using a lot, and I mean, 25 to a turret is probably enough, but I'll be continuing to use it. If I can have it nicely built up before the war, that's always good. And with steel being okay at the moment, that's fine, and it will only use copper if copper's got to the end of the line anyway. Doesn't look like any's being requested at the moment, so that shouldn't cause any disruption to anything, I would imagine. So we will do that. And we'll leave that to do its thing. It'd be good if we had a bit more copper. I'm not sure if there's anything we can do about it, though. We've already got that deposit going. I mean, we could get it being mined quicker. We could compress the miners some more. But the belt's already full. So that wouldn't make much difference. We could upgrade it to red, maybe. As well as the supply line for circuits. Would make a bit of sense. Then again, this already twice as... like, nearly twice as much throughput... maybe even more than twice as much for the copper than the circuits, because it uses two sides of a belt. Advanced circuits, still not great. At the moment the supply is fine, actually. It's just the that the assemblers aren't doing enough. We could... I mean, I made room for another one, but there's pipes and stuff, and it's probably fine. I think if we just leave it, it'll be okay. At the moment we have our 200, which is good. Hopefully it will stay that way. I will go check up on modules. No level 1s there, and not many level 2s either, actually. I'll take what's there. What's up here? Oh, there's nothing in there either. No. It's annoying. We need more. We need more advanced circuits. That's the thing at the moment. Perhaps they'll build up, perhaps they won't. Another thing I realise is that we're going to have to set up production of the level 2 speed and productivity modules, because we use the level 3s in all the stuff we're going to be building once we start getting alien artifacts, so that's not great. That'll use up a bunch more, and it's pretty much what the entire factory is dedicated to at this point, making circuits and trying to get the modules made. Yeah, at the moment this is looking alright. I thought it was worse than it was, but apparently it's okay for the moment. That looks fine. Buffer system's building up. I might help things anyway by wandering up here. Still that attack going on down at the stone. It sounds like it's, the biter is there to stay until we go over and deal with him. Get up here. Oh, inventory's a mess. Let's dump some stuff. It's just gonna end up going into, like, the storage chest, but I've got too much stuff on me. Why can't we just go there? Oh, ah, it's all gone wrong. Actually, how many... we've currently got 450 bots, so it wouldn't be too weird to just dump another 50 into the system. Have 500, nice round number. How many construction bots? 200, we should also put 50 construction bots into the system. Do we have that much handy? Yes, we do. I will go do that. Just to make sure we can deal with whatever is thrown at us. Steady. There. 500 and 250. Excellent. Should be enough for any of our needs. In fact, well, yes, yeah. At the moment, the system is well on. Half of them are being used still, the logistics bots. It's probably iron to a fairly large degree. And I think we're transporting, like, coal miles as well. Yeah, let's just grab a bunch of this stuff. And dump that too. Just to give that deposit something to do. We could potentially hook it up to the logistics system. How far away is it? It's not that far. It's inside construction range, most of the deposit. So that's not terrible. Alright, come on, bots. I know there's enough of you available. Okay, there's only 100 of you. Oh, that's because a bunch of just set off to retrieve stuff from me. The only thing is they're all over the network. having to travel many miles to meet me. So while they do that, I'm just going to make it harder for them and go this way. Actually, they all seem to be coming from the direction of the oil outpost. Well, that was very good. Pretty much all of it in one go. Right, so we've got this coal deposit here, and I was thinking at the moment the only coal supply we have is right up here, and that is hard to defend and stuff, so perhaps we should just start mining this one that we've got. Just sitting here completely unused. I'm going to make as much use as we can of the deposits that we have available. That looks alright. Maybe I should move it up by one. That might make more sense. Yeah, let's do that. A bit like so. The biters are going to hate that, but we'll see. I think there's nothing over there. We'll go here. And then I guess here? Turn this one. Looks pretty good. 8 miners. Move this light out of the way. Belt it along. Oh, there's a bit of ore in the ground. Where did that even come from? Oh, that was from the first one I built, of course. I will just send this into some chests, I think. Just like here. I never remade the parking place for the tank. Poor thing. Like this. I guess I should have a belt balancer just in case. It seems unlikely to cause an issue. In fact, it shouldn't because it's 4 on either side, but I've set it up now, so whatever. Like so. Into an underground belt. And then we'll make ourselves a... He ran straight in, straight out again. I can't complain about that. Wow, I think I got the dimensions perfect, actually, for what I'm thinking of. Just having, like, this. And we need 10 inserters. Put the belts in. That's 5. And now I don't have the level 1 inserters handy. It takes longer to make the fast inserters. There we go. For power, we want a substation. Which apparently will only connect up to that thing up there, and not this one down here. Interesting. We'll have to extend this by one, though. Which is not good, because now our corner meets up with that thing. I want to move it. It seems so integral. It's got so many things going into it. Have I got another one handy? I like to have one in my hand already when I replace something like this, so it doesn't take long. Oh, it only disconnects that substation over there, which isn't a problem. Actually, that's not fixed it. Ooh, it needs to disconnect from... it's okay, it's already connected to one over there. That's fine then. We can put it there without issue. Clear this bit away, and we'll just stick that there. And there we go, we have a nice loading system. Possibly overkill, I mean, the miners aren't on. Which is part of the reason it's not doing much. Did I just mine... A bot? I may have done. Nope, they're all still in place. And we need a substation here. Oh, it's off by one. Can we... Aha! Oh no, it's not in power range. Can we change that? No. That's annoying. Can I move this up by a bit? I think I can. It doesn't look like its position is that vital. Aha! Perfect. Oh, but now it's not powering that one. Oh... I'll just put, like, a normal power pole there, then. Also, we need modules before loads of pollution happens. Not that it's particularly important, but power consumption is also important as well. Let's see how that's looking. We are having the accumulators running at night. Steam engines aren't quite enough to deal with it at all times. Also, it seems like the steam engines are still sort of on during the day, kind of. Which is a shame. But there's more things that we can yet put modules into. There we go, the bots are using the coal supply, because the oil outpost uses it, so that's pretty good. That has shortened their travel distance. Hopefully freed some up, and hopefully uses less power as well. That sentence switched tenses or persons or something there, but I don't care. Still, this is all well supplied and running quickly, but not quickly enough. Maybe I should set up some more production. I didn't think it would be needed, but at the moment it's the only problem. There are plenty of circuits. We just need more advanced circuits. Can I make this any quicker? Unless I put speed modules in, the only way would be making more. Maybe we should do that. Maybe have a sort of smaller scale one here. How quickly is this running? I think we can squeeze a couple more. Oh, that's non-stop. Oh, not quite. I think we can get two more assemblers running off that without a problem on each column, and that would be an increase of a third, which isn't terrible. We can contain this. Oh, that pipe causes problems, actually. I imagine we can just move it up by one, actually, so that's not the end of the world. I will try that. Oh, but then this goes wrong. Oh, it does need to do that, then. Unless we made this really awkward thing. I'm just going to leave it for now. I could put speed modules in if it really becomes a problem. We just need more. More advanced circuits. Always more. How is this now? Another 12, that's not too bad. We're up to 26. Let's go over to some furnaces somewhere. I think the iron one's up in the north, actually, I think. Don't use them. Then again, we would need 32 to cover those. Let's go look at the oil outpost, because I think so far I've just ignored putting efficiency stuff in there. Oh, also pump jacks. We can do those as well. There's some down here, aren't there? I don't know how many pump jacks I have. Like, when I originally set them up, this was wilderness. And I've since expanded towards this area, and I still don't know how many pump jacks I actually use. I'll have to trace the pipes at some point. It might just be the three, but I feel like there might have been a fourth. What have we got here? There's two there, one there. Oh, and then there's like three down there, that's what it is. Maybe some there? I don't know. I've never paid much mind to it, because it's always been fine. Like, there's never been a problem with the oil supply, so I've just ignored it. Also, we've not actually upgraded these yet. Let's just do that thing. It's not particularly vital because they're all off. They've completely finished their work for the moment. It'll be a long time before we use them. I mean, I don't even ever use the mines. Because they damage your own stuff, so if I place them wrong, I could end up threatening the continued functioning. Oh, hello. You're trapped inside this this airlock. Do you want to come out? Maybe? Possibly. That's why I build these things, so that if a biter does sneak in, there's a second line of defense before they can start actually wrecking everything. Why do they always go anti-clockwise when they need clockwise, and vice versa? Oh, don't you go in as well. Make it twice as difficult to sort it. Fine, I'll just wait till you're not over here and then go in. Right. Just give it to everything. I don't know how much these things are really active. What's the pollution normally? 1.8. Not terrible, but could be better. And this brings it down to a much nicer 0.36. And they have twice the pollution, so I really should have put the modules in there. In fact, let's take the modules out, because I do this all the time. I put modules in the things that make less sense to put them in. Let's just go put them in the refineries. It makes so much more sense. Don't you get in? Ooh, that was close. Should have paid more attention to him. He's never coming out, is he? Oh, actually, the oil situation isn't so great. That's quite surprising. Each of the fractions is dropping. Ah, but it's not because of the oil supply. It's because of the refineries. We need more of them. It would appear. There is room to expand it some more. Sort of, it's a bit messy. Perhaps we should then do that. Makes sense. Also, is that the biter attack in stone still? Yep. That's the first time I've noticed it in like the past 15 minutes. That's the thing, I can block those out now. You probably can't, which means it's all the worse for you. You're just constantly hearing that alarm. Then again, at this point, if you've been watching the whole series, you've probably become numb to it as well. And so you have probably at some point been attacked in your own games and not realised because you're so used to hearing the alarms in my videos. I apologise for allowing some of your stuff to be blown up. Can I actually make one? Where is it? There it is. I can. We will put that together. Looks like we have enough room here. We'll sort out the pipes and gubbins. Unfortunately, that is not in quite the right place, but we can move it, actually, so that's fine. It's taking forever to make. Come on. We will build this, and then we will finish the episode for today. In the meantime, I will put some modules into these. Unfortunately, it does mean that the new one I'm going to build will not have efficiency because I've run out of modules. Oh, we do need to move it up by one more, actually. But that's still fine because we know we can move these pipes up without issue. There is an issue in that there are biters here, and they are being annoying and in the way. Right, we'll break this pipe, which will momentarily be a problem for the oil production. But it's fine, maybe. Are you going to move? Ever? Maybe? I'll just belt you away then. Clear out this. Put back the refinery in the correct spot. It's connected up to that one instead of that one. Interesting. And then this needs to go here. This needs to go here. And another one going out, which can go wherever I feel like, really. We'll put it there. We need one here. And we also need two more. We've got an odd number of underground pipes again. Is that... Oh, that's because of that. Okay, that's fine then. For once, it is supposed to be the case. One more, I think, we need. So that one's sorted. This one to here. This one to... Ooh. To here, and then some normal pipes. I'll make 10, that seems like a good number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then we can put a 10th on that corner there. So that works out quite well, I believe. We'll hop out, find a wall, find a wall, find a wall, find a wall. There we go. Slightly worried there that I was. Oh, we forgot to actually. There we go. Give it its thing. And then this one will go here. Go down to here, break these, this goes here, put one there, and then we just need two pipes for the corners, one and two, and there we go. We now have a little bit of extra production to fix the heavy oil. Is that up or down? I think it was 900 and something before, actually, so it was continuing to drop. This should counteract to that, and we should now have a good supply of oil once again. I'm surprised that it was the refineries, really. I was expecting it to be the pump jacks that started to cause me issues. But that's fine. I guess we can get rid of this now. I think this is all done. We will quickly do this. Actually, we're at 23 minutes, but whatever. Is there a bit more here I can mine? No, I think we're done. I think we're 100% done here. There's not a single bit left we can cover. It is all... Nope, there's a bit. One day we will actually finish this deposit. And then the war will happen and we'll clear it anyway and we'll carry on getting more coal. Can I even get the coal out of here at this point? It would appear that the answer to that question is no. It is literally impossible to remove this from... Oh no, no, we can work with this somehow. It might require bots at this point. Wait. Aha! We can go around here. We need to go this way, this way, this way. Underground it to here. Ah! I will mine every last bit of this coal I can. And power. And modules. Right, we're done. That is a bit more coal for the production. To help take a load off our new coal deposit thing that we've got going. And I think with that we'll just stand like... here, and I shall say goodbye, thank you for watching, and I shall see you next time.